few months ago, I made a video showcasing some of my NES collection, which is the main system I collect for. I have a bunch more video game related stuff in here, so I thought I'd also share a quickish video about my studio slash game room slash rarely used guest suite. If you haven't seen that NES video, I'll link to it in the description. For the last 6 years or so, our home has had a dedicated room for the game collection. When we renovated our current house, it came with this weird shack in the backyard. It was every house hunter's nightmare, old carpets, torn up pornos next to more than one Bible, rat shit everywhere. My wife wanted to demolish it, but I convinced her that I could turn it into something better one day. When she became pregnant last year, I finally saw my chance to turn the game room into a nursery, and that stinky claptrap into a dream. So here it is in all its tiny glory. I stripped the walls and floors all the way down to the beams, and then built back up from there with new insulation, new drywall, and some of that rad fit-together fake hardwood for the floors. There were remnants of a sink and a kitchen-esque area, but none of the plumbing or electrical was hooked up. I added in a toilet and a little shower, a kitchenette with a sink and cabinets, overhead lighting, and then just cleaned up, really. That's it. Overall, it's about 240 square feet. Let me show you a few more things before we get into the gaming stuff. Most of our art is up in the main house, but I kept a few pieces for my studio. There's still a bunch left to hang that's piled down here in this cabinet, unfortunately. I do have a couple posters, like this Animal Collective reflective tour poster, which is super rad, and this NES Galaxy infographic one. I made this perler here for my wife Eddie when we first started dating, and somehow it's ended up back with me. It took me like a month to do and was the last perler project I attempted. This here is the desk where I do all my writing and now audio recording for YouTube videos, including this one. Spoiler alert! The desk actually folds up into the wall, I just haven't needed to do that yet. I've been slowly acquiring a bunch of sound and video and lighting gadgets that are starting to pile up over here. I've got a little fridge here with all my beers, LaCroix, and you know, stuff you drink. I owned a bar pre-COVID, and this was an old Red Bull cooler that I cleaned up and took home when we closed. You may notice a lot of Atlanta United banners around. I'm a big fan of my local soccer team, but these are mostly because I'm too lazy to buy curtains, and somehow I have like 10 of these supporter flags. In this bin, I've got my cartridge cleaners, alcohol, Brasso, Q-tips, cable ties, and my weed stash. I was wondering where that went. Under it is this thing that's supposed to make the image resolution better on modern TVs. I never could figure it out though, and I apologize in advance to all the pixel purists out there, but as you'll see in this video, I tend to keep things in a lazy lo-fi. This insanity here is a blanket that my amazing Aunt Betsy crocheted for me. It took her 6 months to do, and I marvel at it every time I come in here. I'll probably do a longer video just about this later on, but for now, everyone give Betsy all the props. So here's the main setup. I got this TV recently on Nextdoor after ours fell over and sprayed glass everywhere in the living room. It's not ideal for retro gaming in any way, but it looks amazing for movies and whatnot. It does at least have multiple component inputs, so I don't have to use a splitter for the Nintendo consoles. Everything is run to their own inputs except for the NES, Genesis, Master System, and Atari, which all run to these coax splitters. Again, not the best video quality when you do it this way. Down here I've got my beloved top loader NES, the Super Nintendo, the N64, the GameCube, and the Wii. No complaints here. There's also the Sega Master System, which I'm pretty sure I accidentally fried by trying this bootleg EverDrive I bought off Alibaba. I'm still pretty bummed about it. Below is the Genesis Model 2 with the Sega CD attachment. I had the Model 1 as well, but I didn't need both down here, so it's resting comfortably in my attic. I kind of have a rule about not collecting disc-based games, just for durability's sake. So that's why you don't see, I don't know, the PlayStation or something. But I already had a few for the Sega CD, so it gets to stick around. The 7800 is last, and I love this thing, but I've never been able to get it to turn on properly. The Atari was slightly before my time, so I can't tell if the system is broken, or if I just don't have the whack and blow techniques necessary to coax it into working. It's a shame too, because it's beautiful, and I've got a grip of games over here just waiting to be played. This guy is a production monitor my buddy Brian gave me when he was working at a studio. If you don't know much about screen clarity and color resolution and whatnot, Just know that these are highly sought after by the purist of the retro gaming world. I've got it set up here like it does something, but sadly, it's not hooked up or anything. It just rests here, heavy as shit, waiting for light guns to shoot it, but sadly, nothing. Underneath is a basket of a bunch of different controllers for various systems. There's a whole Tupperware full of these things in my attic, but here I just keep the essentials like multi-ports and turbo controllers and whatnot. These shelves I built myself. I used to have two CD tower bookshelves, but after multiple moves, the pressboard material was giving out. I probably could have made it a little bigger so it'd be wall-to-wall, but honestly, I think I've slowed down enough on my collecting that I shouldn't really need the extra space. It's nothing special, I didn't wire a bunch of LEDs to it or set up any Nintendo signage, I just wanted something sturdy and simple. Props to anyone out there that went the extra distance when displaying their collections. The top of the shelves is all NES. As I mentioned earlier, the NES collection video pretty well covers it, so check that out if you're interested. The only thing that's really changed since then is that I put my newest game, Mr. Gimmick, in one of these plastic cases, along with the six other rarest NES games I own. It replaced Zombie Nation, which now gets relegated back down to its alphabetical spot at the very end of the Z's. Down here are my portable games. I know, it's pretty sad. My brother-in-law lent me his Game Boy Advance for years, but since I gave it back, I've mostly been playing pirated games on my PSP, and then only when I'm doing long flights. My other brother-in-law gave me this Game Gear and a bunch of games. I already had one, but these things are notorious for having video issues over time, and yeah, neither really works. I tried researching how to mod them DIY style, but it's a little beyond my knowledge, or motivation. Here we've got my modest GameCube collection. Plenty of classics like Zelda Wind Waker, Metroid Prime, Double Dash, which is my favorite Mario Kart, plus a few lesser known games like Eternal Darkness and Beyond Good and Evil. I would definitely acquire more, but I was too slow on the draw here and now GameCube games have become stupid pricey. I don't collect for the Wii, and most of these are thrift store finds that I've never really attempted to play. I do love Twilight Princess and Mario Galaxy 1 and 2 though. Next to those are the Master System games, which are hard to display since they don't have end labels. As you can see with the other games, I don't really display boxes, but here it was easier to just line up the cases than having a bunch of identical black and red cartridges on a shelf. Speaking of boxes, you may notice I don't really have any here. I do have a bunch of cases up in the attic, along with manuals and other accessories and duplicates. I just don't really have room to display all that stuff. I do think they're interesting, but it's never really been part of my collecting spirit. I always just wanted the games. Here's a ton of Atari cartridges. As I mentioned, I can't really get it to work, so they just sit here collecting dust. I think all these came with the 7800 when I bought it, including these Coleco carts. One day I'll get an Atari that will love them properly. Next to that are the N64 cartridges. Like the GameCube, I just kind of grabbed the titles I thought were classics, like Mario and Zelda and all that. Although I'm still missing a few obvious ones, like Banjo-Kazooie, Conker's Bad Fur Day, and yeesh, why don't I have GoldenEye? Honestly, I'm kind of a hater on this system. I just don't think it's aged very well. I tried collecting some of the other recommended titles like Jet Force Gemini and Diddy Kong Racing, but I just don't feel like they have that much to offer. Even Mario 64, which I obviously must acknowledge for its role in 3D gaming, is more infuriating to me than it is fun. On a different topic, unlike the Master System, I decided to finally do something about the absence of end labels, which makes choosing a game a lot easier. Let's see, moving over here, these are all my Genesis games, which are the second greatest in number after the NES. I never owned a Genesis growing up, but all the kids I knew did, so there's a lot of nostalgia here. There's all the classics, the Sonics, the Streets of Rages, the Golden Axes, some of my favorites like General Chaos, Toe Jam and Earl, and Home Alone, which I swear to God is actually really good, plus some rarer titles like Beyond Oasis, Herzog Zui, and Crusader Ascenti. There's so many great games for the system, and pretty much any classic Sega game you can think of, I've probably got. There's definitely still some I'd love to grab, but I feel like I've covered my bases pretty well here. Here's a copy of Ranger X, which I didn't realize was for the Mega Drive and not the Genesis when I bought it, which is why it's sitting apart. Also, there's Pier Solar, which is a recent homebrew RPG that I wasn't too into. Hey, it's the 32X! I've tried a few times to get it working, but it always seems to be kind of fucked up. Not sure why. Can't say I'm missing much, though. Next is my Super Nintendo collection, which is probably the only thing still growing at this point. I never had this system growing up, and for some reason none of my friends did either, so I didn't really get into it until college. I've got the Zelda, Mario, Metroid, all the super classics, deeper cuts like Goof Troop, Legend of the Mystical Ninja, and Street Racer, along with some rarish games like The Twisted Tales of Spike McFang, Ogre Battle, and Kirby's Dream Land 3. The rarest game I own is the only unofficial SNES cartridge out there, Super Noah's Ark 3D, which is the Bible Wolfenstein that requires another game to be stuck on top of it in order for it to work. There's still a ton of awesome games for the system I have yet to pick up, but for whatever reason, Super Nintendo games are really pricey, even for common stuff, so I've got to really build myself up before getting something like, say, Wild Guns. And that's it. Since I started making video reviews, I've been spending more and more time out here, so I thought it'd be cool to, yeah, show off some of the games and consoles and all, but also walk through this little space that I spent so long building and trying to make comfortable. I've mentioned my attic several times in this video, and I guess if people want to see it, I'll make a follow-up where I go through all that, and then I'll probably be done with my tours. There's a lot of random retro stuff up there that even I've forgotten about, so it could be kind of fun to dig through. Anyway, until next week, thanks for tuning in.